Light helps us to see various objects around us. There are different sources of light. These sources of light are categorized as natural and artificial sources of light. Let us learn about different sources of light. Items which produce light naturally are called natural sources of light. For example, sun and glowworm. Items which produce light artificially are called man-made or artificial sources of light. For example, torch, table lamp, and lighted candle. Moon is not a natural source of light as it does not produce its own light. The sunlight that falls on it makes it look bright. Let us learn some properties of light. Light travels in a straight direction. Light is not seen, but the objects are seen when light falls on them. The object through which light can pass partially is called translucent objects. For example, butter paper and frost glass. The object through which light can pass is called transparent object. It can be seen clearly through a transparent object. Air and different gases are transparent as light passes through them. The object through which light cannot pass is called opaque object. It cannot be seen through an opaque object. For example, wood and stone. A shadow is formed when the path of light is blocked by an opaque object. A shadow is always formed in the opposite direction of light. Both solar eclipse and lunar eclipse occur because of these shadows. Let us learn about both solar and lunar eclipse. When the moon comes directly between the sun and the earth, the moon blocks the sunlight from reaching the earth and casts a shadow on the earth. This is known as the solar eclipse. Solar eclipse occurs on a new moon day. Let us perform an activity to show how a solar eclipse occurs. Take a powerful lamp and place it on a table. Take a basketball and place it on a stand as shown on the screen. Tie a tennis ball in between the stand with basketball and the table lamp. The table lamp represents the sun, the basketball represents the earth, and the tennis ball represents the moon. Light the lamp. You will observe that the tennis ball casts its shadow on the basketball, just like the moon casts its shadow on the earth. When the earth comes directly between the sun and the moon, it blocks the sunlight from reaching the moon and casts a shadow on the moon. This is known as the lunar eclipse. A lunar eclipse occurs on a full moon day. Let us perform an activity to show how a lunar eclipse occurs. Take a powerful lamp and place it on a table. Take a basketball and place it on a stand as shown on the screen. Tie a tennis ball behind the stand with basketball and the table lamp. The table lamp represents the sun, the basketball represents the earth, and the tennis ball represents the moon. Light the lamp. You will observe that the basketball casts its shadow on the tennis ball, just like the earth casts its shadow on the moon. Reflection of light. We all have heard the Panchatantra story of the lion and the rabbit. What do you think the lion saw in the water? There was no other lion in the water. The lion saw its own image in water formed due to reflection of light. You see yourself in a mirror. You can see the images of nearby mountains and trees in a lake. This is due to reflection of light. Let us do an activity to understand what reflection is. In a dark, empty room, from the left, shine a flashlight on a mirror. In this case, you will see a bright patch of light on the wall to your right. This means that when light falls onto a mirror, its direction changes. Such a change in direction of light is called reflection of light. Thus, reflection of light is defined as the bouncing back of light in the same medium after striking a surface. Types of reflection. The bouncing back of light in the same medium after striking a surface is called reflection of light. Reflection of light depends upon the nature of the surface, that is, whether the surface is smooth, rough, or shiny. Depending on a surface, reflection of light can occur as regular reflection an irregular or diffuse reflection. Let us see what regular reflection is. When a parallel beam of light falls on a smooth and polished surface, the reflected beam is also parallel and directed in a fixed direction. Such a reflection of light is called regular reflection. This type of reflection enables formation of image. Examples: reflection from a mirror and calm water. Let us learn about irregular reflection. When a parallel beam of light falls on a rough surface, the reflected light is not parallel but spreads over a wide area. Such a reflection of light is called irregular or diffuse reflection. In this case, images are not formed. Reflections from all the irregular surfaces, such as stone, wall, wood, are examples of irregular reflection.
Mirrors. We use a mirror every day. When we look into the mirror, we see our own face in it. What we see is a reflection of our face in the mirror. We can also see reflection of other objects that are in front of the mirror. We can see reflection of objects like trees, buildings in the water of a pond or a lake too.
Mirror and reflections. Mirrors reflect almost the entire amount of light that falls on them. Ask your friend to stand on one side of a plane mirror. Position yourself at such an angle that your friend is visible to you. What do you observe? It appears that he is standing behind the mirror. His right hand appears to be his left hand, and left appears to be his right hand. This is called lateral inversion. He appears as much behind the mirror as he is in front of the mirror. His nose, eyes, mouth, and height appears as they actually are. The colors of his face, clothes, etc. are the same in the image as in reality. Observing rays of light, take a plastic comb with very fine teeth. Fix it as shown in the figure on one side of a thermocol sheet. With the help of binding material, Fevicol, Quick Fix, Fevibond or Cellotape. Fix a mirror by pressing it on the thermocol sheet in inclined position as shown in the figure. We will see the light being filtered through the comb moving in a straight line, and the light is reflected by a plane mirror. Mirror and reflections. Mirrors reflect almost the entire amount of light that falls on them. Ask your friend to stand on one side of a plane mirror. Position yourself at such an angle that your friend is visible to you. What do you observe? It appears that he is standing behind the mirror. His right hand appears to be his left hand, and left appears to be his right hand. This is called lateral inversion. He appears as much behind the mirror as he is in front of the mirror. His nose, eyes, mouth, and height appears as they actually are. The colors of his face, clothes, etc. are the same in the image as in reality. When light falls on an object, it is divided into two parts. Part of the light passes through the medium and changes its path. This phenomena, that is, the passing of light through a medium with a changed path, is called refraction of light. Part of the light goes back to the same medium. Sending of light back to the medium by the object is called refraction of light.
Solar and lunar eclipses. An eclipse is nothing but a shadow cast by a heavenly body. The word eclipse means to hide. The earth or the moon, whichever is in between, obstructs the sunlight. As a result, shadow of one heavenly body falls upon the other. Eclipses are of two types: solar eclipse and lunar eclipse. Solar eclipse. A solar eclipse occurs when the sun, the moon and the earth are in a straight line, with the moon being in the middle. The moon obstructs the light coming from the sun and produces a shadow on the earth. When the moon completely hides the sun, a total solar eclipse is said to occur. At this time, the sun appears like a black circular disk with a ring of light around it. Lunar eclipse. When the earth comes between the moon and the sun, a lunar eclipse occurs. the shadow of the Earth falls on the Moon. If the Earth is slightly out of line, only a part of the Moon gets covered by the shadow of the Earth, and a partial lunar eclipse takes place.